In the 1960s, we got the first televised version of Batman, starring Adam West as the main character and Burt Ward as his colorful sidekick, Robin. But the star of the show was the car, the OG Batmobile. Born in 1966, when a group of artisans took a concept car called the Lincoln Futura, which they had only bought for $1, and turned it into a cultural icon in less than 3 weeks. Covered in high-tech gadgets that were only props, the car overheated constantly and malfunctioned often. Fast forward to today, where master artisan Mark Racop is bringing what were only props into fully functioning reality. For Mark, growing up watching the show began a lifelong pursuit to keep the flame alive, quite literally. Let's see what it takes to build $300,000 Batmobiles, fabricated one piece at a time.
I'm a huge fan of Batman and have been since I was a kid. Fell in love with the action, the music, the color, everything about it, but especially with the Batmobile. I said, someday I want to drive that car. So I was 11 years old when my father took me to Chicago to the Antique Auto Museum. I got to see my first full-scale Batmobile. And this car cemented the dream that not only was I going to own a Batmobile someday, I was going to build it. We have two cars in Australia, we have one in Italy, we have one in England, and the rest are here in the United States. Adam saw one of our cars and he looks at the engine. He says, how many horsepower was that again? I said, 702, Adam. That's great. The car that I had was a piece of junk. Bert was walking around one of the other cars going, well, that never worked on our car and that always fell apart. You actually got that to work? That's awesome.
So you're building them better than the original, really?
Right. Well, everything was science fiction back then. Everything had to be done with wires and with stagehands and sound effects and things like that. And today we can do it all for real. Building a Batmobile is 50% art and 50% science. The science side is the replicatable parts of the car, but the art side requires sculpting and it requires a precision eye. There's about 1,000 main steps in building a Batmobile and about 10,000 sub-steps. So start with a raw fiberglass body, which is up on the lift over here. It's a 22-piece mold that's in our building next door. Aside from hood, trunk, and doors, it's all one piece when it comes out of the mold, and that makes it so much easier for mounting. Our first 25 Batmobiles were Lincoln Town cars.
Okay.
They had about the right wheelbase, they had about the right track width and the like, and I liked the heritage because the original car was a Lincoln Futura.
Right.
But it was getting harder and harder to find the parts to rebuild those. So now we're using a custom-built chassis. That way I can make the wheelbase exactly what it was. So we go from that stage to this stage.
Okay.
The body has been mounted. The doors, hood, and trunk are hinged and swinging, and then the body working begins to tighten up the gaps. We're mainly doing most of that work in fiberglass, and then eventually moving into a light skim coat of Bondo over the whole car. And meanwhile, all the bat gadgets are being made. Rocket exhaust tube out the rear with a propane tank. There's a push button, just like a grill.
Oh,
and
really?
You push that button and you hear tink, 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 whoosh, and a flame comes out the back of it. Brought an electronics expert to do the detectoscopes like on Robin's dash. And it has three LED messages, atomic batteries to power, turbines to speed, Roger ready to move out. Just like Adam and Bert said when they were getting ready to launch the Batmobile each time. On the interior is a blinking, beeping Bluetooth Batmobile bat phone.
Now the phone in the show was like pointless.
Just a prop,
yeah.
They would have somebody plug in from an AC outlet to plug and unplug it.
Now, oh, really?
They didn't even have a flasher unit.
Hilarious.
It was done by hand.
Just that, yeah.
So what was science fiction in 66 is reality today.
Tell me about some of the crazy stuff you install in these.
That weird gold fly swatter thing between the front windshields raises and lowers on a power antenna, and that's called the bat beam. It was capable of cutting through 18 inches of steel or 3 feet of concrete. The first time was used was on the first Catwoman pair of episodes, and it shot kind of a lightning bolt is what their representation of what a laser would look like back then. It's a team of people that work on these. It all depends on which stage it is as to how many people are working on the car at any one time, but there are times when it can be up to 15 people, from an electronics genius to upholstery work that's being done on it to make these custom seats.
All these different unique parts, I mean, are they all like just advanced machined in like a CNC machine or something like that? Like, did you have to plan those out?
We had to plan everything, every single item. And some of them we used to build from scratch, from
oh, wow.
rubber molds, silicone molds,
yeah.
and then make them in two-part resin.
Right.
Now, I found the actual source that George Barris used.
Oh, really?
From back in the day, like the blue triangle knobs that are on the center console.
Yeah.
I found the military surplus store that still produces those knobs.
Oh, my gosh.
So I was able to order new old stock.
Oh, that's cool.
So the steering wheel is made up of many different components. We put a Dakota digital speedometer in there. That's in that gauge cluster. And that's not what they had in 1955.
Right.
They only had a handful of idiot lights and that's it. But our customers are demanding. They want all the gauges to be functional. There's a ton of work in literally every single part of the Batmobile. There's no part that is easy. You can't just go into a local shop and go, I want a Batmobile steering wheel,
right,
or
right.
I want a Batmobile center console. It doesn't work that way. Satellite radio, GPS,
yeah.
DVD player,
all
of it's real. Air conditioning and heat you would think would be impossible inside of an open cockpit car,
yeah.
but because of the air flow over, it kind of creates a
little
cocoon.
Bubble. That's cool. Mm-hmm. Wow.
I got to restore the number 4 Batmobile. This is the one I saw in Chicago that my father took me to at the age of 11. And then I got to drive it in downtown Logansport. I was driving the original Batmobile. From order date to completion date, pre-COVID was about 2 years.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's a long time for somebody that's wealthy, that's used to being able to snap their fingers and have anything they want at any point in time.
Right.
Post-COVID, we're at about 3 years.
Yeah, just more difficult.
Everything is delayed.
Oh, I bet.
With all of the creativity and craziness that goes into building a functioning Batmobile, I'm amazed at how many of the pieces come together thanks to specific trades. Everything from CNC manufacturing, welding, fiberglass, 3D printing, and advanced mechanics all play important roles in bringing this vehicle to life.
The trades are critical for this kind of thing. You've got to have a thick skin and you've got to be willing to take some of that criticism, but use that to fuel you in your journey. I'm living proof to say that yes, you can follow a dream and make it happen. It's so much fun when you're driving one of these down the road to be able to see the reactions of people. You go through your drive-through at your favorite restaurant.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, that'd be fun.
and you see the people plaster to the glass as they're checking things out. It's eye candy, but it's more than that. It's powerful, too. When you're driving one of these cars down the road, you're changing somebody's life for the better.
Mm-hmm.
Because if they were having a rough day before you drove
yeah,
past, they're not having a
yeah,
rough day now, right? One gal was dying of leukemia, and one of her dying wishes was to ride in the Batmobile. And I took her for a drive around town. Her mother said it was the first time she had smiled in 3 months. So how powerful is that? It's just a car.
Well, Mark, seriously, thank you so much for
You're
giving
welcome.
Us a glimpse into the works of art you've been making for quite a while now, since you were 17. I mean, you've upped the game compared to the first one.
Tremendously.
And there's a reason why DC Comics, you were the only person they're like, yes, we officially will license you to do it because you do it so well. It's amazing.
Thank you, thank you.
Now that you see how many different trades come together to build a Batmobile, including CNC machining, we are here at Ivy Tech in their enormous department to see how you can learn these different skilled trades so you can build literally any part you can possibly imagine. Let's check it out.
This is our multi-axis area. Multi-axis is basically the way that industry's going. There's so many possibilities when it comes to the manual side of things all the way up to the latest and greatest in technology. It's not so much you're just going into manufacturing because it opens up the doors for so many different things. Instead of just going, hey, I need to go out and buy this. You know, if you have access to stuff like this.
Yeah, make anything.
Things are changing every day. Processes are updating, cutters, materials that have to be cut, and it just grows. You'll never know everything, and that's the best thing about it.
This specific trade's got so much hands-on, and then you've got extreme high-tech, like
yep.
two, three axis machines.
It may seem daunting, programming, things like that. There's an app for that.
Right.
This is a very niche trade. There's so many different directions you can go.
Yeah,
so.
But like you said, it's cool. There's a million different avenues.
We've had students come through here that worked at Andretti Racing. We have manufacturers that call all the time and say, hey, do you have anybody that we can use? The problem is there's just not enough people going through.
Yeah, well, I think what you're doing is amazing. Like, getting engaged, what would be a next step?
I think one of the things you could do is you could kind of look up your local community college, Titans of CNC Academy. You know, these are all things that provide tools to help you get into this trade.
Thanks for giving us a little bit of insight. You kind of want that hands-on, you know, you love building, but you also love where technology blends in together. I mean, this is a perfect spot.
Definitely, this is a place to be.
Yeah.